two bowls on the previous end were short. It's a sign of nerves. And look, when it gets tense, you'll see this regularly. Players have been nailing the jack repeatedly. And now, when they've almost to the finishing tape, just that 60 centimetres away, and it's difficult to beat because the fingers are trembling, the heart's racing, trying to keep your mind on the job, say, for God's sake, get the right weight. Look at Mervyn's worried look. Got the weight, missed the line. John Bell on the left, the manager saying, come on, Merv. As if he's not under enough pressure.
The way these two have been going, if it was a sparring match, I think both of them would have spent some time on the canvas. Both played some absolute knockout bowls.
Three shots, Brian. Davey's our marker indicating, but 60 centimetres of room all around the jack. Mervyn King, second last bowl on this end.
He'd rather get the shot with this one and save it for his last. Still running. Might fall in. Well, it is the shot.
Not probably as close as Mervyn King would like it. Singles are normally the order of the game, but the quality of bowls, look at that, 2, 3, 2, just one single played. Merv's not happy because he knows he will be expecting Steve to draw this shot, and he will be expecting to go to the mat, set down. He'll have trouble holding the grin back if Steve fails.
Well, I suspect he's expecting that this would be the second set. As Glasson missed with his last bowl of the last end. Well, your prediction was right. Glasson is holding set.
Well, the bowl fell over. Brian Davies, the marker. He's come in for a quick look, and he's still held up one. Yellow. The crowd thought it might have been red.
Trying to give me half
idea. Now, Mervyn King, how's his mindset? If he's confident, he'll draw to there. If he's not so confident, he'll play a bit each way, trail the jack or rest on the bowl. So if he's really confident, he'll dead draw. If he's not too confident, he'll play a bit of weight and hope for a bit of luck. Set down.
Last chance, Glasson's holding set.
Barely down there, sir.
Yeah, he's played very well.
Trails the jack, he'll get more than one, maybe. Well, he could have made two out of that. That is fantastic. Certainly one. And they'll have a good close look, but what a time to play a saving shot. Down set. The bowl came in, just moved the jack. Now, it might have moved the jack far enough away from the bowl of Glasson's out in front. But they're measuring for the second. King would be hoping for two.
He'd be happy with one, Steve. He was set down.
It's only one.
Much in it.
But a good one for Mervyn King. Narrows the gap now and still lives on in the first set of this singles match. On their edge of the seats here at Tweed Heads. Right to the crunch time of this opening set. Glasson just needs one.
Mervyn King, Steve, he needs to nail the jack with his opening bowl, keep the pressure on.
Well, he's done that.
And he's blocked the forehand.
Short of jack, mate, isn't it?
Bowl and a half in front.
Thanks.
And we'll force Steve onto the backhand, which is the wider drawing side. So Steve will be conscious here not to be too narrow.
He is.
Mervyn King needs two more. He's holding one of the three he needs. He will now switch to the backhand and he will be visualising the most gentle of all touches on the jack. Hiding the jack, staying with it. Does not want to sit this on the right side of the jack as we're looking. I'll leave a gap. That's okay. Two.
Glasson down two. Only needs one shot. Desperately trying to get in there. Just steal the shot away from King. Well, what an effort. And he's taken the pain out of it. He was down two, and King could have drawn another one for three, and he would have been holding set, but he's played a good second shot. King will be trying to get another one.
Needs to trail the jack, Steve. Glasson's got a great shot on the plant. Shot bowl will go clean out. Well, never wasted behind. First bowl past the jack. Glasson will convert now. Punch his own short bowl onto the shot bowl. Clean out for a set lie. Mervyn King will find himself set down once again. Well, that was plan B. Steve Glasson will take it.
Well, Glasson had two chances, I suppose. The second chance was to pick up the jack, and he's done it.
Never looked like missing. Didn't it? That's good.
And that's a chance that he grabbed for a set lie. Mervyn King will now play his last bowl on this end, and yet again, he must draw the shot.
30 centimetres only, Steve. The odds are not good. Mm-hmm. The jack is off the centre line. Very difficult shot.
Well, he gave it a mighty effort, but the disappointment as Glasson picks up one and wraps up the opening set. A great set too, 9-6. Crowd still staying and looking with some interest as to what is going to happen in this match. One moment it looked like Glasson was dominating the match, although King has been playing just absolutely fantastic as well, but still couldn't get the shots on the board. All of a sudden, King, if he can pick up two shots, well, we'll go to the third and final decider, and it'll be a whole new ball game.
Mervyn King, just a few ends ago, was looking pretty edgy, and now he's, well, composed, unruffled. He's got his nose in front and playing well. Steve Glasson is the one that's just made a couple of mistakes. That's what happens when you get a little nervous. It just feels good out of the hand. You think you've corrected. You've actually taken weight off. And that's an indication of nerves. Just getting hold of the mind and saying, gee, I wish I could win this second set. I only need two shots. Meanwhile, Steve Glasson's holding two. So what does Merv King do now? Maybe should run up on that gap on the backhand, push something out of the way. He has not played the weighted shots too well, but two ends ago he played the best shot of the match in this direction. He's trying to come around his two short bowls. Low percentage shot, very low percentage. If he fails, he'll be in. Look at the swoop on this bowl coming back.
Make any difference to the head, that last bowl, Brian?
Probably still two down.
Yeah, your shot, Steve.
Is it still a measure for second?
No.
No, thank you.
Well, good news for Mervyn King fans.
Drew second shot. The last ball from King at the back must be second.
Steve would like to perhaps turn the Jack High bowl, the one just short of Jack High on the left. He'd love to turn that bowl over once. Or even a short one. Whoa, wobbled in the back door. It's probably two now.
Well, I can see some fireworks coming here.
The weight was the key. You play good weight, you usually get good luck. And it's two shots to the Australian.
Well, this set, as it's unfolded, a three and a two on the last two ends from Mervyn King just bounced him right back to the lead. And I dare say that Mervyn King is going to have a bit of an up and under at this.
Well, he can't be much worse off than two down, Steve. You're right. Steve Glasson, problem for Mervyn. Steve's got one to play. Depends where the jack goes. He's playing firm. Looks to be in the area. Should at least get one of the shots out. May help.
It looked like it needed a lot more weight than that, Chewy.
Well, most aggression Mervyn King as it ever shows in a game is say dash it or damn. He never really gets wild. Needed the jack to go further back.
Yes, well, he gave it a slap instead of a punch.
And he's probably now kicking himself. He's only one down. That's okay. He's leading 7-4. He's in a good position. Both players have conceded a count of three in this end, in this set. Be hoping it's only one. Steve Glasson wants two.
Well, he's desperately trying for two. That must be close. One out.
Two.
He did make it. Well, beautiful draw shot from Glasson with his last. Now, things get tighter. One the difference. Glasson wants three. King wants two.
Problem for Mervyn King, Steve, is that Steve Glasson, he wants three for the match. King's desperately wants two, but just to draw level. This end, very important. 7-6 to this man, Mervyn King. If Mervyn scores a single on this end, I'll put him right on the springboard, but if Steve Glasson should draw level or go in front, Merv King will be... maybe have a few concerns. Oh, it's King off to the better start.
Well, if Glasson gets a couple here, that would certainly rattle the cage. At the moment, King holds one. This is Glasson's bowl. It's a good one too. Gee, that's a great shot.
Not a good sign. Mervyn King was just clapping his thigh there as Steve walked back, indicating to his opponent, good shot. Virtually he should be thinking, well, that was a good shot, but I'll play a better one. I'll show you how to play them. But shake of the head. Needed more. Looked up above him. I don't think you'd get any help from up there, Merv.
Well, Glasson's got two bowls left to play and he's holding one. If you could make both of them count,
could be the last end of the match coming up. Perhaps Glasson will definitely add a second shot here. And hiding it behind the jack.
Well, the pressure is on Mervyn King. He has two bowls left.
A couple of ends ago, Mervyn was looking like the winner in this set.
It's been amazing the way this match has gone, really, from just when you think that something's going to happen, the opposite jumps in.
Better weight this time. Has he overcooked the weight?
Wonderful ball. That's a good shot. Lassen, despite all of that, holding one, has a chance for a match lie.
Well, he's having a good look. There's a saying, and Mervyn knows, there's a saying in bowls, Steve, if you've got a chance to make the match, you've got to take the risk and go for it. Now, Steve Glasson, look at the scoreboard. He's on six. He's holding one. Needs three. How is he going? He's probably saying, this silly bowl of mine here is stopping a shot in here to turn that out. Will I risk coming in tight, sit that bowl over one roll for a match lie? And I think that is the shot Glasson will attempt. He loves the forehand. Backhand is the safer shot.
Well, perhaps Glasson's just biding his time.
Well, it's backhand, Steve.
Well, this hand turns a lot more, as you mentioned before, and it's still possible to get around his short bowl. Get around his short bowl and just turn the red disc bowl at King's once. He'll make three. Well, he's got his own bowl coming in. What's it going to do? Nothing. King is still one down. That will make the scores level, but King has one to play. And he will be desperately trying to work out how he can get shot.
Wait.
Well, there's a problem here, Steve. Look at this, Merv King, he's studying the head. Well, he is not going to play. That is unbelievable. He is not going to play his last bowl. He's one down. He could have drawn the shot. I don't know why. There was danger if he played overweight. No danger at draw weight.
It was interesting, hey?
Well, the drama continues at 7-all. That's what they're playing for, the Ashes Trophy. And there are some ashes, a burnt bowl, one of the old English woods from years past.
One of Sir Francis Drake's bowls, was it, Steve?
Well, if it was, they wouldn't have burnt it. It would have been worth too much money.
Extraordinary, really, decision of Mervyn King on the last end not to attempt to draw the shot when you're one down. No danger at all at draw weight. It just goes to, well, maybe saying 7-all's not bad. I'll have last bowl on the next end, but...
8-6 is better.
8-6 is better. Well, maybe his decision was correct.
How's that for Jack High, mate? Thanks.
Sure, the spectators here are absolutely bewildered why Mervyn King would not play his last bowl when he was down.
Don't know about you, but I am.
Just a lack of confidence.
I suppose the first thing you'd say to Mervyn King after the match if he won, you'd say, gee, that was a good idea not playing that bowl.
And if he loses, everybody in here at Tweed Heads will go up and say, why didn't you play your last bowl when you were one down?
Well, no doubt about that, but King holds one at the moment. And he'll keep one for the time being.
Actually, you hear of golfers in the sport of golf at the professional level, golfers getting the yips on the putting green, their nerves go, and playing bowls at this level is like a professional golfer playing every shot as a putt. I mean, it is nerve-wracking. Well, it's two shots, but juicy target, lovely channel for
That's
Steve
a bowl short
to work
or something,
through.
Brian.
2 inches short.
And I'm two down.
Two down.
Thank you.
Might see a drive here from Steve. Thanks. Looks very juicy, the target. He's got one behind. He could work off the outside bowl.
Well, he's down set.
He's got two bowls to play. You wouldn't expect him to miss. Maybe he cannot believe what Mervyn did on the previous end. Maybe, wow, what a lucky result. Took one out. Don't think that was in the script.
No, well, he played weight at this. I thought he might have gone harder, but it was hard enough. Punched his own bowl onto one of King's. And only one down. So Mervyn King can draw another one here and hold set yet again.
So getting back to my analogy of putting, Steve, when your confidence goes, if you do get nervous and your confidence, you don't think clearly at all. And, well, Mervyn King, he's got a set lie. He wants to get in behind. Well, maybe okay. I tell you what, after deciding on that previous end not to play his last, but he'd want to win this set.
Well, Glasson drives and puts the... Well, if he moves the jack back about a metre or so, he could win the match. That's how tight it is.
Really, you're right, Steve. But if he plays the fancy shot and just misses the jack trying to put it there, he loses the set. Probably saying you've got to save the set, drive for that bowl, narrow or wide, you get something else that's positive.
Now, there's a bit of a contradiction from you, Sherry. You said if there's a chance to win the match, you play it. So why doesn't he?
Well, he's got to say, what if I miss? It's easier to draw. Look at this. He doesn't know what to play. If I miss, I know I can win the match. I've got to save it.
So Glasson may be going for a save, not a win.
Yes.
He's playing white.
And both clean.
It gets them both to be some fun. Well, he's taken one out. And Glasson holds... King holds one, and he has one bowl left, and he has got room to make it two. And if he makes it two, this will be the set to England.
And he's just drawn a shot on the last two deliveries.
That one or something?
Yeah.
On his backhand. Mervyn King, Steve. So, manager and teammate hoping 60 centimetres of room.
Got one, needs another one for the set, needs to take it to the third and final set and keep England's hopes alive in the test match. Well, millimetres away. Millimetres away from getting inside the bowl for two, but it's only one now. That could come back and haunt him.
She was bend then.
He's trying to come home.
King leads by one.
I thought you were wide, and I thought Stanley go pretty quick. I thought, oh no, you're right.
Crowd interested in this. A tense moment in the match now. This would almost certainly be the last end of the set. King wants one. Glasson wants two. Glasson for the match in the series. King to keep his hopes alive and push it to a third set. Needs a good start. Oh, and he's got it too. Brilliant. Well, Glasson has four bowls and he's on the chase. Down set. Wants the shot, at least with one of his four. Won't be this one. King. What does he do, Shuey?
Well, he's got the set lie, and it's a very good one shot he's holding that he needs, Steve. He does not want to sit this close to the jack on the left-hand side of the line. Either on the line or behind the jack. Behind would be better than short. Nerves. He's worried. It's up to Steve to get the bowl off. How much weight? Look at this. How much weight will I drive it off? He might drive and try and clip it off.
Yes, he's playing weight.
He's got his own bowl. It looks to be narrow. Oh, well, he's lucky, you know. He's taking his own bowl. He hasn't got a bowl on the rink, but he's lucky that the nearest bowl is further away from the jack.
Well, it makes it drawable now for both players, doesn't it? As you can see, he gets the edge of his own bowl onto the one that was very close to the jack. The king still holds, but there's now more room.
Yes, so Mervyn King, he needs to nail the jack quickly. And he doesn't like it. Look, willing it on, but he could be... Yeah, well, Steve Glasson, he's three down.
Well, three doesn't matter, really.
Three and one are the same. King needs one, but if Glasson draws this shot and King fails, Steve Glasson can win the match again. He's nailed it.
He has nailed it. Well, from a almost hopeless position... Glasson.
Interesting head.
Just picked this jack up, stuck with it, and now King, the dilemma. He must get close because Glasson has a chance to draw another one for the match.
Well, big choice. How juicy does this look? But if he misses, he leaves Glasson too much room. He's either got to draw close or draw close there and hope that he only goes one down, Steve. Cannot think about playing weight. There's not... The second shot is 3/4 of a metre away.
And I dare say playing this hand, he can't draw the shot, so he's trying to ensure that he gets a nice close second.
Must miss his short bowl.
Well,
it's still running. That's as good as he could have expected. Fall over, 30 centimetres behind.
So playing the waiting game, Mervyn King. Says, I'll back myself and wait for that elusive one shot. I'll get it on the next end. Glasson has a chance to make two now. How does he do it? He's only got one bowl in there. Well, any mistakes, disaster.
Well, I don't think Mervyn King will get another chance. There's two shots on. I think Steve will play delicately here, but the safer shot is to come in here on the backhand. It's on either hand. He's holding one. He needs two for the match. Backhand draw. Come on, he says. You can do it. Only 30 centimetres of room.
Holding one. Can he make it two? That'll be the test match in the series to Australia. Is he got enough weight for it? Oh, thank you very much. Just give me one chance. That's all I want, said Glasson. And he's taken it. What a brilliant shot and what a fantastic match. But Steve Glasson has won the match 9-6-9-8 as he's congratulated by his teammates. Not only the match, but that's the series to Australia.
Well, you say you don't sense it when you're playing the match, Steve, but that was a very entertaining game.
There's some big shots played, I think, at numerous times. You know, we both sort of held numbers at times and someone to play a conversion shot to get out of it. So a couple of loose ones here and there, but generally I thought a high-quality match and some really big pressure shots played at times. So, look, I'm just thrilled to bits to get the win up. It's great.
Speaking of pressure, that last shot, you're playing for the set, the match, the series. What thoughts do you try and keep out of your head?
I think when Merv was playing his last bowl, when I saw he's playing the forehand, I figured he probably wouldn't draw a shot unless it was a freak bowl. So straight away I started thinking, well, okay, there's every chance I'm going to be drawing for the game, to set, the match, the test series, everything. So once he'd sort of missed, and he played quite a good shot, I was just focusing on, you know, I wanted to make my mind up exactly what shot I was going to play. And that was my first sort of consideration. And then fortunately got on the mat and everything seemed to be clear in my head and away we went. So it worked out well.
He made an interesting decision in the eighth end of that second set where he chose not to play his last and conceded the shot to you.
It's probably a confidence thing. I mean, sometimes you step up on a length and you feel you can, you know, draw toucher after toucher or whatever. And he had dropped a couple short and sort of got one good one in the head. Perhaps he felt that if he's a bit quick, he could turn his own bowl out or something. He was happy to concede one and still be right in the match. And whether it's a right decision or not, he'll probably consider that later on. But it wasn't a bad decision, but perhaps now he might look back and think, well, maybe I should have tried to draw a shot. So it's one of those iffy ones.
Well, there's no doubt that we saw some top draw bowls from world-class players there. Steve Glasson and Merv King giving us a great match. Australia securing the series. But there's more to come. We still have the triples match in this final test. Should be some fun too when Glasson, Jeffrey and Johnson take on Merv King, Stephen Farish and David Holt next week. It'll be here again at the Tweed Heads Club and I do hope you can join us. I'm Steve Rebilliard. Goodbye for now.